Hello everybody, Tom here, and today I would like to talk to you about a DIY tarp and a ridgeline kit that I got from whoopieslings.com. DIY tarp. I didn't build, a friend of mine built it, and he's got an excellent video and tutorial on how to make this exact tarp. And it's got an 11-foot ridge line, and it's about 60 inches wide. It's a pretty standard tarp. This one's pretty nice, being that it was homemade. And I'm going to put a link to his tutorial on how to build this exact tarp over on his page, so you guys can take a look at that if you'd like to build a DIY tarp. Okay, so here you can see a little bit of a size comparison. This is 30 feet of 550, and this is the ridge line. It's 30 feet. This is made of a Dyneema fiber. It's 2.2 millimeter, and it weighs in at about 23 grams, or 0.81 ounces. And 30 feet of 550 cord weighs in at 2.12 ounces, or 61 grams. So there's a little bit of weight difference there. All right, so this ridgeline I got from whoopieslings.com, and he sells ridgelines already put together with your choice of accessories like Dutch clips and whatever. I opted to get a custom ridgeline built, and WhoopieSlings goes way out of their way to with their customer service. They're really, really good at getting right back to you and building exactly what you want. And I just wanted the 30-foot ridge line with a couple of soft shackles that I'll show you guys in a little bit. All right, when I go to set up my ridge line, all I do is take the working end and kind of just give the rest of a toss over to the other tree. All right, so the first hitch that I use is called a mooring hitch. It's extremely easy to use. It's really fast. And it's really strong too. Okay, so we come around the tree like so. Take your working hand, come over the top, twist, and bring this through. And that's it right there in a nutshell. And if you want it to be a little bit stronger, you can make your loop a little bit smaller like that and just bring in another loop. And it's not coming out. And that's the mooring hitch. I'll do that one more time for you, and then I'll do a close-up. Come around your tree, come around, twist like that, just bring that through, pull it tight. It's a mooring hitch. Okay, so you come around your tree, you form a loop like so, make sure it goes underneath, take this over the top, and you pull a loop through just like that, and you can slide it forward. And like I said, if you want, you just make it a little even stronger, you should pull another one through, and that ain't going nowhere. One more time, make a loop, make sure it's on the bottom, bring that across and through. So here it is, just a little bit faster. Around your tree. There's your loop. So on the bottom, take that through. Cinch her up. Won't go anywhere. Okay, for my tensioning knot, is one that I'm sure a lot of you guys have seen. I've seen Ray Mears do it and a bunch of other guys. But come around here. Come around your tree. Like so. And since this is Dyneema fiber, I have to do a couple of extra twists in here. But all I do is just throw it over once, twice, three, Okay, and on my fourth one, we'll come over the outside one, like so. Leave a little loop right there, and there's your slippery hitch, half hitch. And then you just tension her up. All right, so this is the next knot that I will sometimes use. Sometimes I'll just use a trucker's hitch. But this is a knot that I've seen all the famous guys use, like Ray Mears and whatnot. This is just a tensioning knot. As you come around, once, twice, and three times, so it kind of looks like that. And then on this time, I come around this one as well as the back one, and then just pull a little slippery hitch right there. So that's what it looks like. Let's do that one more time. So come around once, twice, three times. And like I said, you can do this as many times as you want, depending on the rope that you use. Then you come around the outside one, and you just pull a slippery hitch in, half inch in there, just like that. And you just tighten her up. All right, so here is the soft shackle. And what it does is it's just a piece of Dyneema fiber, and it feeds back in on itself and makes this loop closable. At its most open position, you feed the knot through. Like so. And then you just close it up. And it's like a carabiner, or it just takes the place of a carabiner. It's attached as a prusik on the line, so it's movable. And what I'll do is I'll attach the center part of my tarp to this, and I've got one on the other side as well. All right, so now all I'll do is go over to my tarp. And that's the ridge right there. I've got it in the snake skins, but I'll just run my soft shackle through the loop here, and we'll get her set up real quick. And I'll come over to the other soft shackle. And since they're on a prusik, all they need to do is tighten her up. And just tighten her up a little bit, and we're all set up. All right, and I've got snake skins on this tarp. I believe I got these from Wilderness Logics, and that's wildernesslogics.com. And as you can see, having the soft shackles on either side make it really adjustable. I can move it this way or that way, however I got my tarp, my hammock, or whatever I got underneath here. But like the snake skins, because it's easy to deployable. All right, so what I do for my guy out points is I usually don't have to adjust these very much, or if I do, it's it doesn't take me, it's not hard to just move the stake, but I just do the marlin spike. Put that in there. Just like so. And pull it tight. All right, we got the tarp set up on our ridge line here. Actually, I've opted to go underneath of it, but you can go over the top. It doesn't make a whole lot of difference. Just depends on you. One of the really cool things about the Dyneema fiber is that it doesn't stretch.
You know, 550 cord, you got to keep, you know, playing with it until it stretches to its maximum. But this doesn't stretch, so it'll be as taut as you make it. And just to give you guys a shot of the amount of room in this thing, it's huge.
All right, so there you have it, guys. This is my tarp setup for the time being. And just would like to say thanks to Frankie. He stopped by on his through hike of the Pacific Northwest Trail, and it was great having him here, and pretty awesome tarp. So go over to his channel, and he'll show you exactly how he made this thing. And it's got a lot of room on the inside. It's the biggest tarp that I've got to date. So great accessory for the hammock, or even just to sleep underneath of it. It's pretty huge. So till the next one, you guys, take care out there, and we'll see you down the trail.